everybody, crazy Russian dad here with you, and I'm going to talk about sex education in Soviet Russia. And I know all of you are like, finally, he's talking about something entertaining. I will give you the executive summary first, okay? There was no sex in the Soviet Union, and there was no sex education in the Soviet Union. There you go. But if you want the juicy details, then you need to continue watching my video. There was this famous phrase, there is no sex in the Soviet Union, and I will tell you where it came from. In 1980s, there was this program. In Russian, they call it Telemost, which was like a television bridge. It was what we would call today a talk show, okay? But there was no talk shows in Soviet Russia. There was this auditorium of people in Russia, and there was the auditorium of people in America that also participated. Two people who led it, Phil Donahue.
Vladimir, для меня большая честь приветствовать вас.
You know, from American side, and Vladimir Pozner, you know, on the Russian side. And then the whole nation basically was watching what those Americans were saying. Very interesting program. It probably deserved its own video. But at some point, somebody asked, you know, the Russian side, like, what about sex in the Soviet Union? Okay, and basically there was this one lady on the Russian side who stood up and famously announced to the whole world, there is no sex in the Soviet Union.
Sex on us. Нет, мы категорически против этого.
Yes, everybody laughed, even the Russian side. Even the KGB informants that were in the auditorium, which was probably like everybody. But basically, yes, in the Soviet Union, sex was a taboo subject. Sex was like, you know, for the bourgeoisie and for the, you know, decaying imperialistic pigs, you know, capitalists everywhere, they have sex. We, you know, the Soviet citizens, we're a new kind of people. We don't have sex. We build communism. Even in the movies, okay, when they portrayed love, the best love to portray in the movie would be the love for the motherland. And in those cases where they had to show some romantic love between like a boy and a girl, they would show them being affectionate towards each other. Not too affectionate, okay, it had to be done all in moderation. But the true love that they experienced was not just for each other, but together they loved the kolkhoz and they loved his tractor. Also, parents did not talk to children about sex. And maybe that's why I did not know that there was like a difference between boys and girls until I was like, I don't know, 18 years old. Nobody taught you about sex, and yet the assumption was that somehow you learn. You learn on your own. Or maybe you learn on the street. Or maybe you learn from your friends. Or maybe something else. I don't remember any other sources for this information. And by the way, because nobody was taught anything about sex, you could be like strutting around like freaking Casanova, the best lover in the world. I may need to edit this part about Casanova. So there is no like parents talking to children about birds and bees in Soviet Russia, you know, how they do here in America. In fact, I remember a new friend of mine here in America, when I first arrived, asked me about this and said, didn't your parents have like a talk with you about, you know, birds and bees? And I was like, birds and bees? I know birds and I know bees, but my parents were not into biology. He was like, birds and bees, just sort of how they do it, you know, sort of using that as the analogy. And I was thinking, oh my God, Americans are perverts. Why would you think about how birds and bees do it? So anyhow, Soviet parents did not talk to the Soviet children about birds and bees. So what did happen? I did promise to tell you like how sex education was approached in Russia. So I will tell you. There was a class, I think in high school or maybe late middle school. I forget the name. I am pretty sure the word sex was not in the title of the class, but it was probably called some kind of a health education. We were very intrigued, we were very excited, we were very interested. But all of this was very short-lived. I don't know what they showed and said to the girls, but I will tell you what the boys experienced. We had this teacher, she was at least a million years old, and for the whole semester, or maybe for the whole year, she was telling us stories about this French poet or French philosopher from this like 18th century. But this poet or philosopher was imprisoned, and he spent 20 years in prison. But for those 20 years, he was writing letters to his lady friend outside. For the first 10 years, he was not sure about his feelings, and so they were just exchanging letters. But finally, after about 10 years, his feelings have become crystallized, and he understood that he felt love for this lady. And I'm thinking, after 10 years, oh my God, because I was like 15 at the time, okay? But yes, after 10 years, he felt like he was in love with her, and then for the 10 years more, he was writing love letters to this lady. I am sure it was full of symbolism, I'm sure it was deeply meaningful, but this lady was a million years old and I was 15 years old and I could not relate to any of this. Now maybe it was about abstinence, if you're in prison for 20 years, all you do about your love is you write letters, I am not sure. For me, that sex education class in Soviet Russia taught me that if I'm ever stuck in prison for 20 years, I should be writing love letters, you know, to my love outside prison. So there you go, fanatics. This is how they taught sex education in Soviet Russia. That is, they did not teach any of the sex education. I'm amazed any of the Soviet citizens were able to procreate. Of course, these days Russia is a new country and independence and freedoms and all of that. And I'm sure they now teach, you know, sex education much better than before. Thank you very much for watching my video. As always, please like my Facebook page, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and buy my merch. And good night.